This show is presented by 2Pound Sports and Entertainment.
Hello everyone, I'm Patrick Connor here with Karen A. Tate. We're back at the Clackamas Armory for another fight night with 2Pound Sports and Entertainment. Tonight we're on the fourth installment, and that means that we have a special exhibition between Steve 2Pound Forbes and DeMarcus Chop Corley. Tonight, the headliner though is Andre Keys out of Tacoma, Washington. He's fighting Antonio Neal out of Spokane, and we also have Chris the Truth Johnson in the co-main event fighting William Hernandez. Couple other good fights on this card, though, Karen.
Yeah.
A lot of local talent.
Yeah, it's really exciting that we have six fights total, including the exhibition, and we have a lot of young, up-and-coming prospects who are going to be really hungry and ready to show what they're made of and move to that next level. So it'll be exciting.
Very exciting night here for us. Let's get it kicking off with our announcer.
Folks, tonight's event is sanctioned by the Oregon State Athletic Commission. Our referees in charge of the action will be Joel Scobie and Joey Passarella. Our judges tonight are Jim Howard, Andy Dinger, and Perla Gonzalez. Doctors on hand this evening are Mark Wells and Kevin DeWeber. We've got a special treat for you. Next up is a three-round exhibition match featuring former world champion boxers right here for you tonight. Let's bring him to the ring. Blue corner to the ring, please. Blue corner. Can we have red corner fighter to the ring, please? Red corner.
Didn't even get a chance to say that DeMarcus Chop Corley, of course, is known for some of his flamboyant ring outfits, and they're custom made, of course. And he's been doing that ever since the late 90s, I believe. And actually, his son, DeJean Corley, who we saw in the opening bout, also had a very similarly tailored set of trunks. Yeah. It's a talking point in any event, Karen.
This next matchup is three rounds of exhibition boxing featuring former world champions. Here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. His professional boxing record stands at 51 wins, 33 losses, and one draw, with 28 of those wins coming by way of knockout. From Leesburg, Virginia, he is the former USBA super lightweight and WBO junior welterweight world champion. This is DeMarcus Chop Corley. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, his professional record stands at 36 wins, 14 losses, with 11 of those wins coming by way of knockout. He is the former USBA super featherweight and IBF junior lightweight world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Steve 2Pound Forbes.
Referee instructions in just a moment for this special three-round attraction, exhibition between Steve 2Pound Forbes and DeMarcus Chop Corley. Now, of course, the question is, what exhibition, Karen? What does that mean? Well, that, of course, means that they're wearing headgear, and these gloves that you're going to see in just a moment are much bigger than your regular or usual competition gloves. Usually those are going to be 8 ounces or 10 ounces, depending on what division. These are 16 ounces. So they're wearing headgear, 16-ounce gloves. It's essentially a sparring session, as it were. Mm-hmm. But I spoke with both DeMarcus and Steve recently. I said, what do you expect to happen tonight? Are the punches going to be real? Are you going to be fighting? What's going on in there? And he said, well, they both said we're very competitive people. We both like to win. Neither of us is going to want to get in there and be done up or, you know, showed up by the other guy. So while it is going to be friendly, they said the punches are very real. Here we go with this special three-round attraction between Steve Forbes and DeMarcus Corley.
Forbes utilizing that jab really well right from the start.
Thus far, not really throwing or landing much hard yet.
Yeah, I mean, I know they're very competitive and there'll be some decently hard shots in there. They're not pity pat punches exactly, but I think they're pulling their punches a little bit, as they should. It's just an exhibition.
Yeah, there's no need to beat the heck out of each other for an exhibition.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, one of the things they had, both DeMarcus Corley and Steve Forbes had also said in the lead up to this exhibition, was that they felt something you and I were talking about earlier, Karen, is that some of these arts in boxing, some of these aspects of boxing have been lost over the years, and especially over the last few decades. And so they wanted to give, especially fans in the Pacific Northwest, the opportunity to see two former world champions get in there, pull a couple tricks, do some cool stuff, and, you know, see something that they normally would not get to see.
Absolutely. Yeah, this is such a treat. I mean, this is such a treat. Both of these fighters are just tremendous talents. They both, you know, have the fundamentals that we were, like you said, we were just talking about, that old school fighters had an abundance, and some of it has been lost in modern boxing. And for people with a sharp eye and who are kind of learning about the techniques and the artistry of boxing, the martial art of it, this is a treat. And you can see, you know, I think we're just getting a plethora of things here to talk about, but
right,
their positioning is phenomenal, both of them. And, you know, one of my favorite things about Forbes has always been he's so good at staying, you know, sitting in the pocket and not getting touched much. He was always great at that. And, you know, of course, he learned under the Mayweathers, and kind of they specialize in that sort of style. But he's utilizing that really well here and just moving his head really well, really great defense. But my favorite thing is he's fighting, you know, DeMarcus is a southpaw, of course, and I think a lot of times when an orthodox fighter fights a southpaw, they neglect the jab. And they think for some reason that that's not going to work so well, but Steve is not neglecting that jab, and he's utilizing that really well. And you can see it makes a difference. A jab, no matter what stance fighter you're facing, is going to help you land your own shots and keep them at bay a little bit.
Now, some fans might watch this and say, hey, man, where's the violence? Where's the blood? Where's the guts? But, look, this is boxing. This is not brawling. You know, these are two professionals in there, two former world champions, two guys who have something to show. They have something to prove, perhaps, too. And, they're both in their 40s. They're both making a comeback, as it were. DeMarcus Corley has been more active than Steve Forbes has in recent years, but they're both still professional fighters. Neither of these guys have retired. I specifically asked that question, you know, just to make sure, because with this being an exhibition, I didn't know what the intentions were.
Yeah.
But they said that they're both very much in this, and they both feel as though they haven't really taken that much punishment in their career.
Yeah, and I think that's true. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Steve is 42 and DeMarcus is 45.
Right.
But yeah, as you can see, I often look with older fighters, you can often see their age a little bit in their legs. Typically, you know, they're just a little more stiff, a little bit slower. And both of these fighters still have quite a bit of bounce and stuff. And yeah, I'm sure that's why they didn't take much punishment earlier in their careers. And, you know, again, that defense is why, you know, and it's just tremendous to see.
Now, one of the things that DeMarcus Corley had emphasized to me when I spoke to him is that he's in tremendous physical condition. And you can see that he very obviously is. That's one of the keys to his longevity, he said, is that he has made sure DeMarcus Corley with a couple of trap blocks, too.
Yeah.
He's still trying to do it right there.
Yeah.
One of the things he had said, though, was that eating right, taking care of his body, making sure that he's actually slowing down on a lot of the sparring, he says, in his later years.
Oh, that's great.
But those kinds of things are the things that have made him just capable of carrying on as a professional fighter when, by all means, he should be pretty much finished, especially considering the Floyd Mayweather fight was almost 17 years ago now.
Yeah. Yeah, I love Steve's combination punching. And yeah, DeMarcus is just, he throws a beautiful jab himself with that right hand as a southpaw. And a nice lead left there. And again, I have to talk about their positioning. It's just so important. It's such a subtle part of boxing. But if you notice, you know, you look at the young fighters that we were just watching on the card and compare where these fighters are so experienced and have just so much top level, you know, world class experience, and just the placement of their feet, and it's just a beautiful thing.
Corley landed a good left hand a moment ago, southpaw left hand. I think that Steve Forbes has been a little bit more dedicated to the body.
Yeah.
Not exactly scoring this fight, but he's been going to the body a little bit more steadily. Funnily enough, I was just about to mention that DeMarcus Corley likes to throw a long right jab to the body, which is exactly what he's doing right now.
Yeah.
However, his power punch, his punch that he tends to get the most power out of, it, he sets up very well as his right hook. That right hook from a southpaw stance is a very compact and usually very short, because of the way that an orthodox versus southpaw fighter, because of the way that they're positioned, it's generally a very short hook from that southpaw stance. Very effective if you can hone it in.
And especially, I think, with this headgear on, you know, it's going to be really hard to see that hook, and it'd be hard anyway, but especially with headgear. And yeah, I see, you know, Forbes is throwing more in combination, and Corley is a little bit more precise with his punches, a little more accurate, but he's throwing fewer.
Grinning at each other a little bit there, I can see through the headgear. So it's nice to know that they're maintaining a bit of a friendly aspect to this.
Yeah, they're definitely enjoying themselves in there.
It's some of Steve Forbes' family and friends in the crowd saying, "Pound, you better not sit down. Look at DeMarcus Corley, he's not sitting down." Hey, this is an exhibition, but apparently even the people in the crowd are taking it pretty serious.
Yeah. Everybody's competitive.
Well, I think that, you know, that's something that we were speaking about earlier, is things that are easily forgotten or easily overlooked in boxing. Mm-hmm. Something in boxing that's easily overlooked is the competitive nature and the drive of a lot of these fighters, and what that can do for a fighter, too.
Definitely. I would imagine, too, as you get on in years, that becomes even more important. You know, you have to find motivation in different things, and I would think that would be a big motivator.
Well, as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast, DeMarcus Corley won the WBO Junior Welterweight title from Felix Flores in 2001. I believe it was January 2001, if I'm not mistaken. And he won that in with a first-round TKO. Now, Felix Flores was actually in the same camp as Felix Trinidad, trained by Felix Trinidad Sr., was a highly touted prospect, and I believe DeMarcus Corley was actually rated number 10 or 11 at the time, and it was a big source of controversy because people felt he did not deserve that title shot. And of course, less than one round later, DeMarcus Corley wound up winning the WBO title, and a few months later, DeMarcus' son, Dijon, was born. Now, you couldn't get a better motivator than that, I don't think.
Absolutely. This is beautiful stuff. I love, too, they're kind of trading hooks, but they're both slipping really well.
I think the angles that they're using, mm-hmm. some grinning there again, the angles that they're using, the way that they're pivoting and using their lead foot is just, it's exquisite for somebody who really appreciates that.
Definitely.
Should be noted that, of course, Steve Forbes, not exactly known for his punching power, even at lighter weights, definitely more of a stylist, as it were. But you can also see, if we're being honest, that he's carrying just maybe an extra pound or two around the midsection, being that this is an exhibition. So perhaps that can put a little bit more oomph into his punches or maybe give him a little bit more physical leverage. But otherwise, this is just fun.
Definitely. And, you know, speaking of punching power, I think a lot of times people who haven't fought combat sports may overlook that nobody likes to be hit. I don't care how hard somebody hits or not. You don't like to be touched by punches, so it's always effective. And he's the type of puncher, I think it's very sharp and accurate, so it doesn't necessarily have to be a knockout punch to be effective.
DeMarcus Corley puts his gloves down, starts moving his head like a, basically like a snake charmer, like they used to say about Prince Nassim Ahmed. And of course, what does Steve Forbes do? Three punches to the body.
Yeah, that's beautiful. What do the old timers would say? You know, they can move their head, they aren't moving their body, right?
Got it.
So you go to the body.
Picking up a little bit of steam here toward the end of the third round as they're actually sitting down on their punches a little bit more.
Yeah, I think they're kind of getting warmed up now.
Yeah, we want to just throw an extra round onto this?
I know, right? That would be amazing. Yeah, that was fantastic.
Now, I would imagine that Steve Forbes is actually going to get on the mic, and they probably both will, to be honest, but one of the things that both Steve Forbes and DeMarcus Corley talked to me about in the lead-up to this is saying that this is something they'd like to do regularly, not them, Steve Forbes versus DeMarcus Corley, but
DeMarcus, Chop Corley, and Steve 2Pound Forbes.
Other less active fighters, older fighters, etc., giving them an opportunity to still stay active.
Absolutely, and it's a great way, like you said earlier, to showcase those fundamental, phenomenal skills that are sometimes lost in modern boxing to, you know, a younger audience or to younger fighters, and get to see how great these fighters are still, even at 42 and 45.
Well, actually, a little tidbit about Steve Forbes and DeMarcus Corley. Steve Forbes was actually one of Corley's sparring partners for the Floyd Mayweather fight, so he has been in the ring with him before.
All right, DeMarcus Chop Corley, how you feeling after that three-round exhibition?
I feel great. I mean, God has blessed me to be 45 years old, still fighting at the weight I turned pro at, 140 pounds.
Talk about these boxing gloves that commemorating a fight.
Oh, yeah, this is a fight that I'll never forget. Zab Judah versus Chop Chop. He won a split decision, and it was unfinished business. That's how I had the gloves made.
Very nice. I like it. Talk about how it feels for you at this age and stage in your career to have the youth of your family carrying on the boxing tradition within your family and how it makes you feel to see them out here doing their thing?
It's amazing. I mean, my 18-year-old is following in my footsteps. He didn't get the decision tonight, but it's back to the gym, hard work for him. My 7-year-old, I mean, it just brought joy to my heart to see him shadow boxing, spot me in front of everyone and not be shy. He really has a sport and a passion for what he's doing.
It's awesome to see. Thank you for being here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, DeMarcus Chop Chop Corley. All right, and Steve, 2 Pound Forbes, how about you? How you feeling after that exhibition?
I feel good. Chop, you know, when I gave him a call and said, you want to do an exhibition? I said, what are you doing? I just finished working out. So Chop is always in condition, and we thought it would be fun, kind of show some old little tricks. But no, it was great.
From what I understand, you guys have sparred before back in the day, but you never got it on in a professional matchup. Let's go ahead and throw it out there. Who do you think would win if that happened today?
Of course I got to say me, but Chop, you know, is such a veteran, and I did help him get ready when he fought Mayweather, and I was fighting 10 pounds less, you know, at 130, and he was champ at 140. But we always been around the gym and been in the same gym with each other, camps, so it's a pleasure to get in with a fellow world champion and just, you know, mess around a bit.
Absolutely. And now your namesake is 2 Pound Sports and Entertainment. Where do we see this promotion going from here?
Well, you know, we had a steady build on stage right now, but we're going to keep it up. Appreciate you guys coming out. We heard 205 was closed down, but, you know, I appreciate you guys coming out. This is just fun. This is something we want to do. We're going to bring other guys here that you guys know that are active fighters, getting ready for fights, and they'll come in and perform for you guys.
Absolutely. Thank you for having us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve, 2 Pound Forbes.
I want to thank all y'all for coming out. I have a big announcement. I posted on social media earlier today. It's a big announcement. So now it's time to let everyone know. I will be crossing over. I'm going into the BKB bare knuckle fighting. Oh. I'll be doing a pro debut of the bare knuckle BKB fighting sometime in October. I will continue to box with my boxing career, but I want to see if they can stand to go toe to toe with Chop Chop in a bare knuckle fight.
We wish you the best of luck at that, and we know you'll do awesome. Thank you.
This show is presented by 2 Pound Sports and Entertainment.